Welcome friends, today we will discuss about aortic regurgitation. This condition can result from either disease of the aortic valve, cusp, infection, trauma or dilatation of the aortic root. The causes are summarized in box 1688. Pathogenesis. Regurgitation of blood through the aortic valve causes the left ventricle to dilate as cardiac output increases to maintain the demands of the circulation. The stroke volume of the left ventricle may eventually be doubled and the major arteries are then conspicuously pulsatile. As the disease progresses, left ventricular failure develops, leading to a rise in left ventricular and diastolic pressure and pulmonary edema. Now, what are the causes of aortic regurgitation? It is divided into congenital and acquired. Among congenital cause, the bicuspid valve or disproportionate cusp. From acquired cause, the causes are rheumatic disease, infective endocarditis, trauma, causes of aortic dilatation, Marfan syndrome, aneurysm, aortic dissection, syphilis, and ankylosing spondylitis. Now, the clinical features of aortic regurgitation. The symptoms are mild to moderate aortic regurgitation, often asymptomatic, palpitations. In severe aortic regurgitation, there is presence of breathlessness, angina. In signs, for signs, the pulses have different signs. Large volume or collapsing pulse, low diastolic and increased pulse pressure, bounding peripheral pulses, capillary pulsation in nail beds. It is named as Quincke's sign, femoral bruit or pistol shoot. Its name is Doherty's sign. And head nodding with pulse, the name is the Massett sign. Murmurs, there is presence of early diastolic murmur, there may be systolic murmur due to increased stroke volume and Austin Flint murmur, soft mid-diastolic murmur. Other signs includes displaced heaving apex beat, that is for volume overload, pre-systolic impulse, fourth heart sounds, crepitations, pulmonary venous congestion. Clinical features. Until the onset of breathlessness, the only symptom may be an awareness of the heartbeat, particularly when lying on the left side, which results from the increased stroke volume. Paroxysmal nocturnal dyspnea is sometimes the first symptom, and peripheral edema or angina may occur. The characteristic murmur is best heard to the left of the sternum during held expiration. A thrill is rare. A systolic murmur due to increased stroke volume is common and does not necessarily indicate stenosis. The regurgitation jet causes fluttering of the mitral valve and, if severe, causes partial closure of the anterior mitral leaflet, leading to functional mitral stenosis and a soft mid-diastolic murmur, which is called Austin Flint murmur. Acute severe regurgitation may occur as the result of perforation of an aortic cusp in endocarditis. In these circumstances, there may be no time for compensatory left ventricular hypertrophy and dilatation to develop, and the features of heart failure may predominate. The classical signs of aortic regurgitation in such patients may be masked by tachycardia and an abrupt rise in left ventricular and diastolic pressure. The pulse pressure may also be normal or near normal, and the diastolic murmur may be short or even absent. Now, the investigations. Doppler echocardiography is the investigation of first choice for detecting regurgitation. In severe acute aortic regurgitation, the rapid rise in left ventricular diastolic pressure may cause premature mitral valve closure. Cardiac catheterization and aortography are usually performed to assess the severity of regurgitation, to determine if there is dilatation of the aorta, and to screen for the presence of coexisting coronary artery disease. MRI can also be useful in assessing the degree and extent of aortic dilatation if this is suspected on chest X-ray or echocardiography. Here the table shows the investigations in aortic regurgitation. In ECG, it may be initially normal, later left ventricular hypertrophy and T-wave inversion may occur. In chest X-ray, cardiac dilatation may be aortic dilatation and features of left heart failure. In echo, there are presence of dilated left ventricle, hyperdynamic left ventricle, Doppler detects reflux, fluttering anterior mitral reflex. In cardiac catheterization, which is not always required, there may be seen dilated left ventricle, aortic regurgitation, dilated aortic root. Here the echo diagram shows colored jet of aortic regurgitation and a lean patient forward with breath held in expiration to hear early diastolic murmur best. Here the diagram shows dilated left ventricle and aortic valve and dilated aorta. The diagram also shows increased pulse pressure. The early diastolic murmur is best heard at the left sternal edge and may be accompanied by an ejection systolic to and from murmur. The aortic arch and left ventricle may become dilated. The inset shows a Doppler echocardiogram with a regurgitation jet. Now the management. Treatment may be required for underlying conditions such as endocarditis or syphilis. Aortic valve replacement is indicated if aortic regurgitation causes symptoms, and this may need to be combined with aortic root replacement and coronary bypass surgery. Those with chronic aortic regurgitation can remain asymptomatic for many years because compensatory ventricular dilatation and hypertrophy can occur, but should be advised to report the development of any symptoms of breathlessness or angina. Asymptomatic patients should also be followed up annually with echocardiography for evidence of increasing ventricular size. If this occurs or if the end systolic dimension increases to 55 mm or more, then aortic valve replacement should be undertaken. If systemic hypertension is present, vasodilator should be used to control systolic blood pressure. There is conflicting evidence regarding the need for aortic valve replacement in asymptomatic patients with severe aortic regurgitation. When aortic root dilatation is the cause of aortic regurgitation, as can occur in Marfan syndrome, aortic root replacement is usually necessary. Thank you, friends.